Here I'm going to briefly describe what's meant by evaporative cooling. So imagine we have a liquid like water in a container. And of course the water is going to try and reach equilibrium. So water is going to be evaporating to try and reach the saturation pressure of water in the gas phase. Now this can be a slow process. The evaporation will speed up. If we were to flow some gas over it, sort of removing the water, then we're going to keep evaporating the water. And so what we want to look at to visualize evaporative cooling, suppose we have a container that's completely insulated. In other words, the container is adiabatic. And by adiabatic, of course, we mean that there's no heat transfer. Q is equal to zero. So as the water evaporates, because this container is adiabatic, the remaining water is going to decrease in temperature because the energy for evaporation has to come from somewhere. So it comes from the sensible heat of the liquid that remains. If we have a small amount of liquid, then we could have a significant change in the temperature. In other words, this is the cooling you experience when you get out of a swimming pool and the water liquid on your arm evaporates and you feel cooler. And so what we want to do is do an energy balance on the system. And so delta U is Q plus W. That's for a closed system. But now this is an open system, so we have an additional term due to the enthalpy change because of energy flowing out. Now delta U, because this is a liquid we're talking about, so our system is the liquid, so it's the heat capacity of the liquid, the mass of the liquid, the final temperature, and of course then minus the initial temperature. So this is the energy change as we're evaporating. Adiabatic, so Q is zero, W is zero, and delta H is removing energy minus delta H of vaporization. In other words, we have to provide energy in order for the liquid to evaporate. And so heat of vaporization then would be a positive number. So overall, this is negative. And of course, overall, this is negative because the final temperature is less than the initial temperature. Now, I left out something important, and that's the mass evaporated. So this delta H is heat of vaporization, for example, per gram of water, and then the mass of water that evaporates determines what this temperature difference is. More evaporates, higher decrease in temperature. And so this is the idea of evaporative cooling, that we apply energy balance to a system and we observe that we can cool down a liquid by evaporating some of it, and the remaining liquid then gets colder.